hacking and slashing with cyber-implanted flails, mattocks and cleavers. Arco-flagellants fight on dementedly until there's nothing left of their foes but a pile of mutilated corpses. In this video, we're going to show you exactly how to paint your Arco-flagellant up to battle-ready standard using the contrast painting method. These easy-to-follow tips and stages so you can get your units of Arco-flagellants on the battlefield, smashing the enemies of the Imperium in the face in no time at all. Now, first of all, we've prepared our model by spraying it with Wraithbone spray. And once that's dry, it's time to move on to the contrast stage. Now, we're going to be painting the flesh on our Arco-flagellant first because it's the largest area of the model. And there's lots of different paints you could use for the flesh, but we've chosen to use Cygor Brown for ours. And for this, we're using our medium shade brush. So let's get straight to it. So let's take our Cygor Brown and put a little bit onto our palette, just like so. Now, we're just going to be making sure we're not overloading the brush with too much paint and making sure we've got nice fine points in the brush as well. There we go. Perfect. Then, onto our Arco-flagellant. We're very carefully going to be painting the flesh like so. Now you want to apply quite a thick coat of contrast paint onto the Arco-flagellant here, as the more contrast paint you put on, the better contrast you get between the recesses and the higher area of the model. Also, try and be as neat as you possibly can, but don't worry if you make a mistake, we can always go back later on and touch up the model with a Wraithbone paint in a pot. Also, as you're painting around the miniature, try and make sure you're avoiding the paint pooling in certain recesses. For example, you can see down here we've got the paint pooling in this recess at the bottom of the leg here. I'm just going to poke it around here to make sure it's a nice even coat, to make sure it's not gathering in the recesses. Once this is dry, we'll move on to the next stage. So there we go, that's the flesh tone applied on our Arco-flagellant, and it's time for the next stage. All right, up next, let's hit those metallics all over the miniature with Basilicanum Grey. Now, this is going to be the flails, the helmets, the collar, the shackles, any other metallic parts of our miniature. And again, for this, we'll be using our medium shade brush. So let's take a little bit of paint from the pot again and just put it onto our palette like so. Again, we're not thinning this down, we're just making sure there's not too much paint on the brush. Perfect. Then, onto our miniature. This is going to be nice and easy. We're going to be painting all the metallic bits. So hit the flails here, the helmet, the shackles, collar, anything else you can see that's on the model that's metallic, hit it with Basilicanum Grey. And once again, making sure we're not letting the paint pool in the recesses, we're just very carefully painting it on here and trying to avoid any areas that aren't metallic. But don't worry if you do, we're going to go back later on and touch those up. There we go, that's dry and the metal's looking pretty cool, but you can also see we've made a couple of mistakes here. Look, a bit of Basilicanum Grey has made its way onto the cloth here. There's also a few other bits of the miniature not quite as tiny as we'd like, so we need to sort that out. So before we put any more contrast paints on, we're actually going to go back and touch up those areas using Wraithbone base paint out of a pot. And for this, we're using our medium layer brush. So let's get to it. Let's take a little bit of paint from the pot here and onto our palette, and I'm going to thin this down to a touch with water to help it flow onto the model a little easier. Then, onto the miniature, we're just going to touch up all those areas that we've made a mistake. So here we go, we're going to go over the cloth here, like so. Just very carefully touch those bits up. Anyway, we're going to be applying contrast paint in the future. We want to be painting with Wraithbone now, to make sure it's nice and solid base coat, ready for those contrast paints going down later on. So, there we go, we've picked out the parts of the model we've not yet painted with Wraithbone, and we're ready to move on to the next stage. Alright, so up next, let's put the rest of the details down onto our Arco-flagellant. Let's start off by painting the cloth with Agaros Dunes. Then we're going to pick out the flail and other parts of leather with Black Templar. We'll use Nazdreg Yellow to pick out the tag around her neck and other parts of golden detail on the model as well. Then we're going to use Skeleton Horde on the face mask, and finally Ethematic Blue on those weird stim injectors on her back. First of all though, it's time for Agaros Dunes on the cloth, and as this is fine detail, we'll be using our medium layer brush for this. So let's take a little bit of paint from the pot here and onto our palette. Again, just making sure we're not overloading our brush with too much paint. Bingo, perfect. Then, onto our miniature. Let's paint Agaros Dunes all over the cloth of our Arco-flagellant like this. Now, again, here, be real careful to be as neat as you possibly can, but don't worry if you do make a mistake, you can always go back with that Wraithbone paint in a pot and touch it up if you need to. Also, at the same time we're doing the cloth, we're also going to pick out the rock underneath her base as well. So that's painted too. Next up, we're using Black Templar again with a medium layer brush here to pick out some areas of the miniature, such as the leather on the flails here. I say leather, it's basically sort of like hard plastic bits of the flail here. And also any leather on the miniature as well, so if your model has any straps or anything like that at all, pick those out with Black Templar too. Alright, up next we're using Nazdreg Yellow to pick out the tag around her neck to give that sort of golden appearance. We're also going to use this on various parts of the metal too. Now, this will go over the Basilicanum Grey quite easily, so we can happily pick out parts of the metal here. For example, I'm going to pick out the handle here in gold or bits like this here. This is really to your own taste. You can do this really to break up the metal bits to make the model look a bit less one colour. There we go, we're going to put the same round the sort of trim on the top of a helmet here as well. There's no right or wrong place to put this, just paint it to your own taste, and once that's done, we'll move on to the next stage. Next up, we're picking out the face mask with skeleton horde. Just very carefully touching it in there, like so. Make sure here you're not hitting the face or the yellow bits or the metal. Just be as careful as you possibly can, just touch the face mask there. And the last contrast paint we're using is Ethematic Blue, which we're painting onto the stim injectors on our Arco-flagellant's back. We're also going to use it in a couple of other places as well. First of all, we're going to place it onto the flails here, on the power ports going down here to give it a nice warm blue glow, like power's coming out of the flail there. We're also going to use it on the lens on her eye at the front as well, just again to make it look like it's a nice glowing light coming out of the head there. So there we go, that's the contrast paint applied to our Arco-flagellant, and she's almost ready for the battlefield. There's only one thing left to do, of course, and that's to apply a textured base to our miniature. Now for ours, we're going to use the Agrellum Badland texture paint to make it look like she's loping through the desert, but you can of course use whichever texture paint you like for your model. Now as always with a texture paint, we're going to be using our trusty Citadel texture tool, so let's get straight to it. First of all, we're going to take a little bit of paint from the pot and apply it to our texture tool like so, a bit of a dollop. Perfect. Then onto the miniature. We're going to be just be spreading it on top like so, with the thick end we've taken out of the pot, and then we're going to flip the tool around and use the thin end just to spread it around the base like so. Now be super careful to make sure you don't hit the model as you do this, but a nice even coat all over the base is what you're looking for. Allow about an hour for it to fully dry, and once it has, we're going to be painting the rim of the base with Steel Legion Drab. So there we go, with the base dry and the rim of the base painted Steel Legion Drab, our Arco-flagellant is ready for battle. And that's how you can paint units of your Arco-flagellants up to battle-ready standard using the contrast painting method. Couple of things to remember here. First of all, when you're applying contrast paints, try and be as neat as you possibly can, but don't worry if you make a mistake, you can always go back with the original base paint colour, in this case Wraithbone, reapply that and put contrast paint over the top of it. Second of all, when you're applying contrast paints to large areas such as skin or the cloth, make sure you're not allowing it to pull in the recesses, so you're moving your brush around to make sure it doesn't pull and gather. Alright, that's all from me. Happy painting!